Waitrose is the sixth biggest supermarket in the UK, and they hold 4.8% of the market. The Waitrose mission statement states that its intention is to merge the convenience of supermarket with the know-how of its service and shop management, and also provide customers a price commitment to create the customer confidence that they always get the good product and service value for money when shopping at Waitrose. When it comes to customer service, Waitrose is currently ranked as the number one supermarket in the UK. However, competitors like Marks & Spencer are not too far from winning this title. Why might Waitrose risk losing its foothold on customer service? Let's first have a look at their operations. Operation processes are important because they all transform inputs into outputs, which provides the service or creates a product. However, what makes a company unique is how they use the 4 V's in different ways to provide the product or service. Waitrose offers a large selection of products, meaning they have high variety. They also sell a great quantity of products on a daily basis, meaning they have high volume. Although customers have frequent contact with Waitrose, the stores show merely the tip of an iceberg of their operation, such as shipping from suppliers. Therefore, they have medium visibility. And finally, Waitrose has overall a relatively steady level of demand throughout the year, meaning they have low variability. By the combination of these 4 V's, Waitrose provides a fantastic service. However, we believe that their service could be even better were it not for lack of efficiency in one of their key processes, which doesn't let them keep up with their high volume. Let us introduce to you one major challenge that we have encountered in their operation. Meet Jacqueline. She comes from Sweden, the land of efficient operations. Having moved to London, Jacqueline loves grocery shopping at her new favorite store, Waitrose. That's where she buys her milk and bread and all other yumminess. But there's one thing Jacqueline hates about shopping at Waitrose: their checkout counter. Jacqueline is really not happy with this. If the system would have been efficient, maybe Jacqueline wouldn't have felt so dissatisfied. While waiting in line, Jacqueline has done 7 calculations of the idle time of the cashiers over a 10-minute period. She found that during rush hour, the cashiers are idle 42.8% of the time on average. What is it that is so wrong about the system, Jacqueline wonders. The main problem is that the cashier can only handle one customer at a time, and before he begins to serve the next customer, the cashier has to wait until all products are packed and carried away by the previous customer. This system leaves the cashier idle and Jacqueline frustrated. And when it's finally Jacqueline's turn to pay, she's really stressed about packing as she knows the whole queue is waiting for her. The system creates a dual dissatisfaction among customers like Jacqueline. First, about waiting an unjustified amount of time, and then stressed about packing during the actual purchase. Waitrose is a supermarket that is known for its customer service. However, if customers have to wait a significantly long time and leave feeling more stressed when they arrived, then Waitrose's reputation is in danger. It could even result in customers being lost because they have a negative connotation with their shopping experience at Waitrose and don't think that the customer service is worth more than shopping at a cheaper competitor. The internal effects of this checkout system leaves Waitrose's cashiers being idle for 42.8% of the time on average. This is a devastating resource waste, especially considering that it's a non-value-adding idle time. Will there be a happy ending for Jacqueline and her Waitrose shopping? And will Waitrose manage to keep the ranking in customer service? Luckily, we know just the way how. This video was brought to you by Antonia Foster, Hannah Marshall, Jacqueline Engdahl, and Amelie Lidberg.